let's start our discussion on here in unit number one. Okay, so once again, unit number one talks about home office, no, and branch accounting. Okay, so if a certain business, once again, no, if ang isang business lumalaki na yan, see to it that that business, no, will think of a way on how to expand its business, right? Then one way, once again, one way on how to expand a business is by establishing a branch. Okay, so ibig sabihin ngayon, let's say we have here Mang Inasal. So Mang Inasal, normally nag-start yan, no, sa isang lugar lang. If I'm not mistaken, nag-start si Mang Inasal sa bandang Bacolod. So first, business ni Mang Inasal nasa Bacolod lang. Then kumita siya ng malaki sa Bacolod. Then apparently, anong nangyari? Mang Inasal or the owner of Mang Inasal think of a way on how to expand its operation. Then one way na naisip niya is to establish a branch. That's why nagtayo siya ng branch in Manila, nagtayo siya ng branch in Tarlac, etc., etc. Let's say dito na lang sa Manila. Right? So see to it now, na since may branch siya sa Manila, the operation now, no, of Mang Inasal is not only limited in Bacolod, but will also have its operation in Manila. Okay? So, since the owner, once again, since the owner of this Manila branch is still the Mang Inasal, see to it now that the records, once again, the records, no, of the Manila branch must be the same with the records of the home office, which is the Mang Inasal. By the way, home office, no, is actually the main office. Again, home office is also same, no, doon sa ating main office. Right? Yun yung main office ng business. Right? Pero ganito ang nangyari. Once again, ideally, dapat magkasama yung records nila. It's just that there's a problem. Sir, what's the problem? The problem here is that medyo mahirap, no? It's so difficult to maintain all the records in one location. It's so difficult or it's so parabang inconvenient for the home office, no, to maintain the records of the Manila branch. So since it is inconvenient for the home office to maintain or to record all the transactions of the Manila branch, see to it now that a branch, again, a branch will have its own set of books. Again, meron siyang own set of books. Ibig sabihin neto, the branch normally what? The branch normally prepare its own financial statements. The branch normally record its own sales, its own purchases, etc., etc. Ibig sabihin, itong branch na to, meron siyang own assets, liabilities, and equity apart from the home office. But don't get it wrong. Again, don't get it wrong. The owner of the home office, I mean the owner of the branch, is still the home office. That's why the equity account, once again, that's the reason, no, why the equity account of the branch is called home office current account. Again, the equity account of the branch, no, is tinatawag natin home office current account. So we have the home office current account, which is tatawagin natin HOCA. Alright? So once you heard the term HOCA, right, always remember, no, na dapat yung unang papasok sa isip nyo is that this is the equity account of the branch because the owner of the branch is still the home office. Right? So, sir, paano po yun? If iisa ang may-ari ng home office at ng branch, isn't it dapat iisa lang po, no, yung kanilang financial statements? Well, that's correct. That's why every year-end, no, once again, every year-end, the home office must what? The home office must prepare what we call the combined, again, what we call the combined financial statements, right? Sir, bakit hindi consolidated financial statements yung tawag? Hindi mo siya pwedeng tawaging consolidated financial statements because wala namang parent-subsidiary relationship. Once again, home office, no, is not the parent and then the branch is not a subsidiary. Okay? See to it that home office is a business and then part of the business is the branch. Ibig sabihin, this branch is still part, no, of the business of the home office. It's just that it is so inconvenient for the home office to maintain the record of the branch, right? That is why the branch maintain its own set of books. But even though the branch has its own set of books, at the end of the year or every year end, the home office must prepare combined financial statements. So sir, anong nangyayari dito sa combined financial statements na to? Here, sa combined financial statements, see to it, no, that the assets, liabilities, equity, income, and expenses of the branch and the home office are combined. Once again, assets, liabilities, equity, income, and expenses of the home office and the branch are actually combined. Ibig sabihin, pinagsasama lang. Because as I said a while ago, inuulit-ulit ko, the home office is the owner of the branch. Right? Also, in the combined financial statements, we eliminate what we call reciprocal accounts. So, meron tayong tinatawag, no, na reciprocal accounts. Right? And these reciprocal accounts are actually eliminated. Sir, bakit sila natawag, no? Again, sir, bakit po sila natawag na reciprocal accounts? They are called reciprocal accounts because these are the accounts that are seen in the books of the home office and there is a related account or there is a reciprocal account on the books of the branch. So, ibig sabihin, no, meron tayong account na makikita mo sa home office and then meron siyang counterpart sa libro ni branch. Kaya sila natawag, no, na reciprocal accounts. Okay? So, pagdating sa reciprocal accounts, meron lang naman tayong apat, no? Once again, meron tayong apat. So, sir, ano yung apat na yon? Number one is yung tinatawag natin na home office current account, which is yung na-discuss natin kanina. Again, first will be the home office current account or yung tinatawag natin na HOCA. Alright? Once again, home office current account or HOCA. And then, may counterpart yan sa libro ni home office. Huwag kayong magpapalito, ha? Even though may home office sa pangalan ng account na ito, hindi po siya nakikita sa home office. Saan nakikita yung HOCA? Ang HOCA po, nakikita po yan sa branch. Right? Maraming nalilito, pangalan pa lang eh. Sino ba naman ang hindi malilito? Home office current account, tapos nakikita sa branch, tama ba? So sir, ano yung nakikita sa home office books? Yung nakikita dito sa home office books, no, or yung reciprocal account ng HOCA is yung tinatawag natin na investment in branch account or tatawagin nating IIB, and then meron pa siyang isang pangalan eh, which is yung tinatawag natin na branch current account. So if meron tayong home office current account, meron din tayong branch current account. So ilalagay ko dito, no, IIB or BCA. Okay? So itong dalawang ito, once again, itong dalawang to, reciprocal accounts po sila. What do I mean by reciprocal accounts? These are the accounts seen in one book that has a counterpart, no, to the other set of books. Meaning, for every, once again, listen very carefully, this is important. For every increase in one account, there must be a corresponding increase on the other. For every decrease on one account, there is also a corresponding decrease on the other. So, ang ibig sabihin, kapag dinagdagan or binawasan ng isa, madadagdagan or mababawasan din yung isa. So if you will increase, once again, if you will increase the home office current account, the branch current account will also be increased. If you will decrease IIB account, see to it that the HOCA account will also be decreased. Kaya sila natawag, no, na reciprocal account. Hindi po pwede, again, it is not possible, no, for you to increase the home office current account without increasing the branch current account. If you want to increase the home office current account, you also have to increase the branch current account. And the other way around this is also applicable, of course. Okay? In order for you to increase or decrease the branch current account, you must reflect the same increase or decrease to the home office current account. Okay? Kaya sila natawag na reciprocal accounts. Okay? So HOCA, na-discuss na natin kanina na, na this is an equity account. So let's discuss the IIB or the BCA account. See to it, no, that this IIB or BCA account, on the other hand, is an investment account. Therefore, this is, once again, this is an asset account. Okay? Once again, investment in branch, no, is an asset of the home office. Huwag kang magpapalito sa pangalan. May pangalan sa branch, no, dito, no, investment in branch, saka branch current account, but this is not seen on the branch books. You can see this account on the home office books. Now, before we continue, again, before we continue, no, the discussion of concepts of the home office and branch accounting, let's first distinguish, no, the difference between sales agency and the branch. Okay? Because madalas, pinagko-compare itong dalawang to. Madalas, there are a lot of students, no? Who thought that sales agency is just the same to what we call the branch. Okay? But in substance, hindi po sila pareho. Malaki ang pinagkaiba nila. Alright? So let's start with the inventory. Alright? So pagdating sa sales agency, once again, with regards to the sales agency, see to it that normally the inventory of the sales agencies are just what? Are just the samples. Alright? Because kapag sinabi natin sales agency, the only parabang purpose of it is to sell goods. Ibig sabihin, normally yung inventory niya is yung mga samples lang. Okay? Not unlike si branch. Branch has its own inventories. Again, branch has its own inventories. Ibig sabihin nito, si sales agency, yung mga inventories niya, kinukuha pa niya sa home office. Ulitin ko ha, yung mga inventory or lahat ng inventory ni sales agency, saan niya galing? Kay home office. Because ang function lang ng isang sales agency is magbenta. So ang inventory lang niya is yung mga samples. Pero si branch, gaya ng usapan natin kanina, meron po siyang own set of books. Ibig sabihin, if may sarili siyang libro, see to it now na what? See to it now na may sariling inventory, no? Si branch. Si branch, hindi niya kailangan mag-rely kay home office. Pwede siyang bumili sa labas. Okay? Now, punta tayo sa sales. Pagdating naman sa sales, see to it na yung sales agency, lahat ng sales niya, anong nangyayari? Lahat ng sales niya, right? Sinusupply. All sales are supplied and fulfilled by the home office. Ibig sabihin, kapag may umorder, no? Well, again, pag may umorder sa isang sales agency, kailangan pa niyang ibigay yung order kay home office and the home office will be the one who will fulfill the same. Okay? With regards naman sa sales ni branch, see to it na meron din siyang own sales. Hindi niya kailangan mag-rely sa home office because as I said a while ago, the branch has its own books. Meron siyang sariling inventories. So if meron siyang sariling inventories, it can make its own sales. Okay? Now, let's move on to the resources. Normally, yung resources ng sales agency, yun lang yung tinatawag natin, no, na revolving cash fund. Again, we have what we call the revolving cash fund. Okay? So sir, ano po yung revolving cash fund na yan? Yan lang naman, no, na yung tinatawag din natin na change fund. Yun yung pera ni home office na binigay, okay, sa sales agency para meron siyang panukli. Right? So itong accounting, no, once again, the accounting for revolving cash fund is the same. Once again, this is the same or this is similar to the accounting for a petty cash fund. Ibig sabihin, kung ano yung napag-usapan nating concepts, no, or napag-usapan yung concepts sa petty cash fund, sa accounting for petty cash fund, the same concepts will apply to a cash fund. Ibig sabihin, right, we are still using here the impressed method. Again, we have what we call, no, the impressed fund method. Wherein under the impressed fund method, disbursements, once again, disbursements are not recorded, no, on the date of incurrence. Once again, no, disbursements are not recorded on the date of incurrence. Kailan nire-record ang mga disbursements? Disbursements are recorded kapag nagkaroon ng replenishment. Alright? So, syempre, fund pa din yan. Nauubos yan at nire-replenish. So, kapag nagkaroon ng replenishment of the fund, that's the only time, once again, that's the only time that we can record the disbursement. These disbursements are also known as expenses. Alright? So, lahat na napag-usapan nyo sa petty cash fund, nag-a-apply din sa accounting ng cash fund ng isang sales agency. Okay? With regards to a branch, on the other hand, see to it, no, na meron siyang own assets. Again, meron po siyang own assets, hindi lang cash. Okay? Ang sales agency, cash lang ang meron siya. Pero ang isang branch, meron siyang cash, AR, inventories, etc. etc. Okay? Then, pagdating sa records, see to it, no, that the sales agency, again, a sales agency does not maintain its own books. Again, a sales agency does not maintain its own books. Wala po siyang sariling libro. So all the records, no, of the sales agency are recorded, no, by the home office. Not unlike si Branch, wherein as discussed a while ago, once again, no? As discussed a while ago, Branch has its own books. Ibig sabihin, meron siyang sariling libro. Okay? Internally, ibig sabihin yan, internally, okay? Ibig sabihin sa mata ng home office at ni Branch, the Branch is actually what? The Branch is actually a separate entity. Once again, no? Internally, Branch is a separate entity. But obviously, externally, again, externally, Branch and home office, again, Branch and home office are the same. Ibig sabihin, the Branch and the home office are one and the same. Okay? So internally, meron siya sariling libro. That's why internally, it is a separate entity, but externally, the Branch and the home office are just the same. Okay? So those are the differences, no? Again, those are the differences between a sales agency and a branch. Okay? Now, ganito, punta tayo, no, sa mga journal entries. Alright? So here, in home office and branch accounting, balik lang ako dito, no? Here, in home office and branch accounting, normally, dalawa lang naman yung problems, no? Again, dalawa lang yung problems na pwede mo ma-encounter. Alright? Una, again, first will be the reconciliation. Again, first will be the reconciliation of HOKA and IIB. Because as I said a while ago, tama ba? For every increase in one account, there is a corresponding increase on the other. Ibig sabihin, HOKA, again, ibig sabihin ngayon, ideally, no? Ideally, HOKA and the IIB are the same, has equal value. Parang gana, no? And then number two, again, the second problem here, no? Is the preparation of the combined financial statements. Alright? So, combined financial statements, mamaya natin yung pag-uusapan. Dito muna tayo sa first problem natin. That's the reconciliation part. Alright? So, once again, no, ideally, okay, home office is equal. Again, home office current account, okay, is equal to the IIB and the BCA account. Okay? So, dapat pareho sila. Whatever it takes, dapat pareho sila. But that is just ideal. Right? Most of the time, hindi sila pareho. Bakit? There are reasons. Again, syempre, there are reasons kung bakit sila hindi magpapareho. So what are the reasons kung bakit hindi magpapareho itong dalawang to? Well, there are only two reasons, no? Number one is that there are unrecorded items. Once again, number one will be the unrecorded items. Ibig sabihin ng unrecorded items, possible, no? Na yung home office, hindi siya nag-record. Possible na yung branch, hindi siya nag-record. As I said a while ago, when there is an increase on one reciprocal account, there is a corresponding increase on the other. Kapag nag-debit, right, or nag-increase si home office, mag-i-increase din dapat si branch. If isa sa kanila, hindi nag-record, no, situate na hindi na po, mag-i-equal yung HOKA at yung IIB. Okay? Then the second reason, no, again, the second reason kung bakit hindi sila mag-i-equal will be the errors in recording the transaction. Possible naman din na pareho silang nag-record. It's just that one of the two, either the home office or the branch, ay nagkamali. Akala ni branch, 64,000. 6,400 lang pala. Mga ganong bagay. Alright? So, doon papasok yung first problem natin. Again, doon papasok, no, yung first problem natin, and that is the reconciliation. Again, that is, no, the reconciliation of reciprocal, again, reciprocal accounts or reciprocal balance sheet accounts, which is the HOKA and the IIB. Alright? So, we need to reconcile now the two. And in order for us to reconcile the two, kailangan nating malaman, no? Again, we need to know kung kailan nadadagdagan at kailan nababawasan itong mga accounts na to. Okay? So, HOKA, once again, no? HOKA is what? HOKA is an equity account, as I said a while ago. Since HOKA is an equity account, see to it that what? See to it that the normal balance, again, the normal balance of this account is what? The normal balance of this account is credit. Okay? Kasi ang equity, alam naman natin, first year pa lang, diniscuss na yan, senior high school pa nga lang eh, credit po yan. Okay? Ibig sabihin, if we want to increase, once again, no, if you want to increase the home office current account, you need to what? You need to credit the same, okay? And if you want, again, if you want, on the other hand, to decrease the home office current account, you need to debit it. Okay? So if gusto mong dagdagan, kailangan mong i-credit. Gusto mong bawasan, kailangan mong i-debit. Okay? Once again, home office current account is seen in what? Is seen in the branch books. Nakikita po yan sa libro ni branch. Okay? Ngayon, punta tayo din sa pangalawa. Ano yung pangalawa? The second one is the investment in branch account, also known, no, as the branch current account. Okay? Home office investment in branch account or branch current account, don't get it wrong. This is seen in the home office books. Hindi porket may branch sa pangalan, sa branch na yan nakikita. Alright? So as discussed a while ago, IIB or BCA account is an asset. Again, this is an asset. Ibig sabihin, the normal balance of this account, again, the normal balance of this account is what? Normal balance of this account is debit. Okay? So if you want to increase, once again, if you want to increase the IIB or the BCA account, you need to debit it. And if you want to decrease, again, if gusto mo namang bawasan or i-decrease itong account na to, kailangan mo naman siya i-credit. So even though, ang sabi ko kanina, no, for every increase on one account, there is a corresponding increase on the other, hindi ibig sabihin nun na kapag dinebit mo yung HOKA, i-debit mo rin yung IIB. Medyo magkabaliktad kasi magkaiba or opposite yung normal balance nila. Alright? So if you credited, no, once again, if you credited the home office current account, you need to debit the investment in branch account. If you debited the home office current account, you need to credit the investment in branch account. Because apparently the way on how to increase the home office current account is credit, and the way on how to increase the IIB account is debit. So magkaiba, parehong increase, pero magkaiba. So dapat dito pa lang, wala nang mali dito. Once again, gusto ko walang mali dito. This is crucial because apparently maraming nagkakamali dito sa reconciliation, hindi nare-reconcile because right, hindi alam itong mga normal balance na to. Okay? Nagkakalituhan because they thought home office current account sa home office yan. Branch current account sa branch yan, which is hindi ganun. Okay? So before I move on, chat section once again, are we good with the classification and also the ways on how to increase or decrease the reciprocal account? So ngayon ganito, hear me out guys. Hear me out. There are, or after, dito muna. After reconciliation, once again, after reconciliation, how do we reconcile? Yung pagre-reconcile natin, dalawa lang. Paano? Paano tayo mag-reconcile? Una, we record unrecorded items. Again, record unrecorded items. Okay? So if ang problema is kay branch ka gagalaw. If ang may problema is si home office ka gagalaw. Okay? And the second is to correct errors. Okay? Again, the second is to correct errors. And then after reconciliation, see to it, no, na dapat yung home office current account equal na yan dun sa IIB or branch current account. Sir, what if? Again, sir, what if po? After reconciliation, hindi pa rin po sila bangga. If hindi pa rin sila equal, magduda ka na sa sagot mo. Ibig sabihin, may problema yung sagot mo. Alright? So may way, no? May way para ma-check if tama ka or mali. Alright? So ngayon, ganito. How do we increase? Or when do the reciprocal account increase? And kailan sila nagdi-decrease? Again, kailan sila nag-i-increase in general, ha? At kailan sila nagdi-decrease? Okay? So reciprocal accounts is increased in two reasons or by two scenarios. Dalawang scenario lang, dalawang rason lang. What are those? Una is kapag nagkaroon, no, again, first is kapag nagkaroon ng asset transfer. Kapag sinabi natin asset transfer, whether cash, inventory, PPE, or any asset, no, okay? And the asset transfer is from, again, the asset transfer here is from the home office to branch. Ulitin ko, ah. If there will be an asset transfer from the home office to the branch, reciprocal accounts will be increased. Bakit? Because parang dinadagdagan ni home office yung investment niya sa branch na yun. See to it, that investment in branch is the investment, no, or the asset account or the investment account of the home office to that branch. So kapag may asset transfer, whether cash, inventory, or any asset from the home office to the branch, reciprocal accounts will be increased. Okay? The second reason kung kailan mag-i-increase yung reciprocal accounts is kapag si branch nag-generate ng what? branch generates net income. Okay? Sir, bakit naman ganun? Kapag nag-generate si branch ng net income, nag-i-increase yung reciprocal accounts? The answer is yes. Sir, why? Because as we all know, once again, as we all know, net income, no, or the income summary account is what? The income summary account is close to the equity account. And what is the equity account of the branch? Equity account of the branch is the home office parent account. So if there will be net income or the branch generated net income, that net income or that income summary account will be close to the equity account. In short, the home office current account will be increased. And as I said, for every increase in one account, there is a corresponding increase on the other. So if you will increase the home office current account, the BCA account must also be increased. Okay? Now, punta tayo sa mga reasons, no, kung bakit sila nag-decrease. The first reason kung bakit sila mag-decrease is nagkaroon, no, ng asset transfer. Again, asset transfer pa din, but this time, the asset transfer is from the branch going to the home office. Okay? So if there will be an asset transfer, no, from the branch going to the home office, parang ang nangyari dito is that, parang ang nangyari dito is nagkaroon ng return of investment. Again, return of investment meaning withdrawals, parang ganun, no? So kapag si branch nagpadala ng cash, ng AR, ng PPE sa home office, parang binabalik na niya yung investment ng home office. That's why reciprocal account will be what? Will be decreased. Okay? And then apparently, the second reason, no, kung bakit magdi-decrease yan is because the branch incurred, again, the branch incurred net loss. Same reason with regards to the net income. Net loss, again, net loss is actually what? Net loss is actually close, again, net loss is actually close to the equity account. Ibig sabihin ngayon, if net loss is close to an equity account, see to it na kapag yung income and expense summary account mo, kinlose mo sa equity and it is a net loss, home office current account is actually decreased. Nababawasan yung home office current account mo. At kapag nababawasan, no, yung home office current account mo, expect that what? Expect na kailangan mo rin bawasan yung income. Yung lang, kailangan mo rin bawasan yung branch current account mo or yung investment in branch account mo. Okay? So in general, these are the reasons, no, kung bakit nag-i-increase or nag-de-decrease yung mga reciprocal accounts natin. Okay? Then the way on how we can reconcile, no, the two reciprocal accounts is by recording unrecorded items or by correcting the errors in recording the items. Okay? So how can we record? Again, how can we record unrecorded items and how can we correct the errors? Siyempre, kailangan muna nating malaman kung paano ba i-record yung mga transactions. Tama ba? We need to know first, how do we record the transaction? What will be the correct journal entries on the branch books and on the home in the home office books? Okay? So here on my next page or in the next page, right? Lalagay ko tatlong column. Again, here we have three columns, no? Okay? Hindi pantay, no? Right now, OC ako. Okay na yan. Okay. So here, on the first column, ilalagay natin dito transactions. Again, here, ilalagay ko, no? Transactions. Okay. So meron tayo dito transactions. Okay. Next column, anong ilalagay natin sa next column? On the next column, ilalagay natin dito, no? Home office books. Okay. Ano nga ulit yung nakikita sa home office books? Yung nakikita sa home office books is yung tinatawag natin na IIB account or the branch current account. Okay? And then branch books will be put, no, on the last column. So here, ang nakikita sa branch books is yung tinatawag natin, no, na home office current account. Okay? So nang magpapalita doon, ilang beses inulit-ulit sa inyo yun, Mr. Okay? So now, hear me out. First, again, first transaction of the two. So transaction number one will be a cash transfer, no? Again, transaction number one will be a cash transfer, right? From home office to branch. Again, cash transfer from home office to branch. Normally, itong cash transfer na to, tinatawag din siyang initial investment. Again, tinatawag din siyang what? Tinatawag din siyang initial investment. Alright? So here, kapag nagkaroon ng cash transfer from the home office to the branch, syempre, makaka-receive ng cash si branch. So we debit cash, again, we debit cash in the books of the branch. Okay? Mababawasan ng cash ni home office, that's why we credit cash on the books of the home office. Okay? Now, hear me out. Anong usapan kanina? If there will be an asset transfer, no, from the home office going to the branch, reciprocal accounts will be increased. How to increase the IIB account? To increase the IIB account, we need to debit it. How to increase the HOCA account? Kailangan natin yung i-credit. That's why to increase the IIB account, we'll debit here, no, investment in branch. And then to increase the home office current account, kailangan natin yung i-credit. So credit home office current account. So those are the journal entries, okay, on our first transaction. Okay? Now, transaction number 2. Nasa around 136 transactions lang naman to. Biro lang. Hindi naman naabot din. Okay? So number 2 will be the cash transfer. Again, cash transfer. Babalik ta rin lang natin, no? Cash transfer this time from branch going to the home office. Okay? So cash transfer from branch to home office, sometimes tinatawag din tong what? Sometimes tinatawag din tong cash remittance. Again, sometimes tinatawag din tong cash remittance. Okay? So naka-receive ng cash dito si home office, so debit cash sa libro ni home office. Nabawasan yung cash ni branch, so we credit cash on the books of the branch. Okay? So now, hear me out. If there will be an asset transfer from the branch to the home office, ano nangyayari? Well, the reciprocal accounts are actually decreased. How to decrease the IIB account? Kailangan natin i-credit. So credit, IIB here. Okay? Then how can we decrease? How can we decrease the HOCA account? Kailangan naman natin yung i-debit. So we'll debit here, home office current account. Okay? So these are, no, the journal entries. Again, these are the journal entries on the second scenario. Okay? So third transaction, no, will be the shipment. Again, third transaction will be shipment of inventories. Again, shipment of inventory, syempre, from home office to branch muna tayo. Okay? So if there will be, again, if there will be shipment of inventories from home office to branch, at cost, right? The journal entry will be what? The journal entry, no, is to debit investment in branch account, because if there will be an asset transfer from the home office to the branch, once again, nag-i-increase yung reciprocal accounts. Okay? That's why here, i-credit din natin, no, yung home office current account. Again, i-credit din natin dito, no, yung home office current account. Okay? So ngayon ganito. Supposedly, once again, supposedly the correct entry here or the correct credit here is inventory, because nagpadala ng inventory si home office. Eh. Then the correct debit here is inventory as well, kasi nagpadala, naka-receive ng inventory si branch. Right? But apparently, that is not the term we're using here. So here, let's introduce the third and the fourth reciprocal account. As I said a while ago, no, there are 4 reciprocal accounts. Apat po sila, hindi lang po sila dalawa, no? So let's introduce the next set of reciprocal accounts. So here, sa libro ni home office, we have what we call the shipment. Again, we have what we call the shipment to branch account. Again, meron tayong tinatawag na shipment to branch account, which is tatawagin na din natin STB. Okay? On the books of the branch naman, meron tayong tinatawag na shipments from home office account, which is tatawagin naman natin SFHO. Okay? Again, we have shipment to branch account, then we also have the shipment from home office account. Okay? So, balik ako doon sa discussion natin kanina. Okay, nasa na ba yung discussion natin kanina? Bakit iba to? Sorry na. Iba yata itong napindot ko. No? Okay. So, lalagay ko dito number 3 and then number 4. Okay? So, number 3, lagay ko dito, no? Shipments. Again, shipments to branch account. Okay? And meron din tayong tinatawag na shipments. Okay? From home office account. Tatawagin natin itong STB. Ito naman, tatawagin natin SFHO. Okay? Now, hear me out, guys. Hear me out. The first two, again, home office current account and right branch current account or what? Home office current account and branch current account, always remember, must be always equal. Again, must be always equal. So whatever it takes, kailangan pareho ang amount ng home office current account mo at ng investment in branch account mo. Okay? But on the other hand, no, yung shipment to branch account and yung shipment from home office account, hindi po required. Again, it is not required na equal sila. So not always equal. Again, not always equal. Okay? That's why we do not consolidate actually, no? We do not reconcile actually, no? The shipment to branch and the shipment from home office account because hindi naman sila always equal. Later, makikita nyo, no? Marirealize nyo kung bakit sila hindi always equal. Alright? While the other reciprocal account, which is the home office current account and IIB, nire-reconcile natin itong dalawang to because lagi silang equal. Okay? So, ngayon ganito. Since hindi natin ginamit, no, yung inventory account dito, asahan mo ngayon na what? Asahan mo ngayon na kailangan natin i-explain on how to compute the cost of goods sold. Okay? So, isn't it, ang computation natin ng cost of goods sold normally is what? Normally, it's equal to beginning inventory. Again, this is equal to beginning inventory. Okay, nalagay ko rin dito sa kabila, no? Beginning inventory plus what? Plus what we call the net purchases. Plus the net purchases. And then apparently, ang nakocompute natin dito is what? Nakocompute natin dito yung tinatawag natin na total goods available for sale. Again, if you will add beginning inventory and net purchases, ang turo sa inyo sa AC4 is that ang nakocompute mo dyan is the total goods available for sale. Tama ba? Then here, we just have to deduct, no? What? We just have to deduct what we call the ending inventory. Again, i-deduct mo lang, no? Yung ending inventory. And then apparently, that's it. This is already what we call the cost of goods sold. Again, ito na yung tinatawag natin na cost of goods sold. So, ganun lang mag-compute. Again, ganun lang po mag-compute ng cost of goods sold. It's just that may problema. Sir, anong problema? Hindi nagbawas ng inventory si home office. So, if hindi nagbawas ng inventory si home office, see to it now na yung total goods available for sale ni home office is overstated. So, kailangan nating magbawas ng something dito para makorrect. Since hindi nag-debit ng inventory si branch, see to it now na yung total goods available for sale ni branch is understated. So, meron pa tayong kailangan i-add dito. Okay? So, to complete the computation of the total goods available for sale now, see to it that in the home office books, shipment to branch is actually deducted. Ulitin ko, ha? In the home office books, you need to deduct shipment to branch in order for you to compute the cost of goods sold and the total goods available for sale. On the books of the branch, on the other hand, see to it that shipment from home office is actually added. Again, shipment from home office is added. Bakit? Kasi nga understated yung lumalabas na tigas eh. So ibig sabihin ngayon, if dinidact mo na, no, yung shipment to branch and then inadd mo na yung shipment from home office, nakokorrect na itong mga to. Nagigets? Okay? So lagi mong tatandaan na medyo kakaiba na yung computation natin dito ng total goods available for sale. Okay? So now, buburayin ko lang ito, ha, para may susulatan ako. Kailangan ko kasi ng space eh. Okay? I know, sanay ka naman ng marinig yun. Kailangan ko ng space. Joke lang. Pag merong humingi sa'yo ng space, no, padala mo siya sa Mars. Right? Para, no? Para hindi na siya makabiktima pa dito sa Earth. Biro lang. Right? Now, punta tayo sa number 4. Number 4, transaction number 4 will be the shipment of inventories pa rin, no? Shipment of inventories from home office to branch, again, from home office to branch still, but this time at build price tayo. Once again, the shipment here is at build price. Sir, anong ibig sabihin yan? Well, ang ibig lang naman sabihin dito is that pinatungan, right? The home office put a markup on the what? On the shipment of inventories from, right, the home office to the branch. Hindi niya sinip yung mga inventories at cost. Sinip niya yun at build price. So, tinrate niya si branch as another customer, as another consumer. Ibig sabihin na yun, right, yung marireceive na inventories ni branch overstated. Alright? So, let's say here, meron tayong what? Meron tayong cost which is equal to 100,000. Example lang, no? Then, build price natin is, sabihin natin 20%, 20% above cost. Again, 20% above cost. Okay? So, here, ang journal entry natin, no, sa branch books will be to debit shipment from home office still. Again, we'll still debit shipment from home office. It's just that the shipment from home office will be equal, no, to 100,000 times 120% because at build price nga, binil tayo at above cost. That's equal to 120,000. Okay? Apparently, what will be the credit? Credit will be home office current account, which is equal to 120,000 pa din. Okay? Ngayon, the amount of increase in the home office current account must be the same to the increase, right, sa branch current account. So if HOCA is increased by 120, see to it now that investment in branch account must also be debited by 120,000 because by hook or by crook, the amount of increase to the one account must be the same to the other account. Kaya sila natawag na reciprocal account. And kaya ako sinabi kanina na always equal sila. Okay? It's just that hindi naman lolokohin, no? Hindi po lolokohin ni home office yung sarili niya. Okay? Hindi siya katulad mo na niloloko mo yung sarili. Joke lang, no? Medyo bully ba si Sir Rain? Alright? So si home office, hindi niya niloloko yung sarili niya. What do I mean by that? Alam niya na yung shipment of inventories, alam niya na yung cost ng inventories na shinip niya is 100,000 lang, hindi 120. Si branch, wala siyang kaalam-alam doon. Again, the branch is not aware with regards to the markup. That's why the branch recorded the same at 120,000. But apparently, the home office, syempre siya yung nag-ship niyan, alam niya na hindi naman 120 yung cost. Alam niya na 100,000 lang. That's why shipment to branch, no, is credited by 100,000 pesos only. Okay? So sir, paano yan? Hindi po equal yung journal entry nyo? Well, that's true, no? Hindi talaga equal yung journal entry natin because kulang pa ng 20,000. So yung 20,000 na yun, i-credit natin yun sa tinatawag natin na FOB account. Again, meron tayong tinatawag na FOB. Sir, anong ibig pong sabihin ng FOB? FOB, again, kapag sinabi nating FOB, this is actually the allowance, no? Again, this is the allowance for over valuation. Again, allowance for over valuation of branch inventory. Alright? So, the branch inventory is overvalued. Right? By the way, this FOB account sometimes is also known as the unrealized profit because apparently, hindi mo dapat pagkakitaan yung sarili mo. Since the home office is the 100% owner of the branch, situate na, hindi dapat pagkakitaan ni home office yung branch. That's why it's sometimes called unrealized profit. Okay? So the other 20,000 is credited to unrealized profit or to allowance for overvaluation of branch inventory account. Okay ba tayo dun? So ngayon ganito. Pag-usapan natin, no, yung shipment terms. Again, meron tayo ditong shipment terms eh. Alright? So, ano yung shipment terms natin dito? Okay? Meron lang naman tayong dalawa eh. Okay? Na kailangan pag-usapan dito. Sir, ano yung dalawang yan? Meron tayong tinatawag na frayed prepaid. Again, we have what we call the frayed prepaid. And then, meron din tayong tinatawag na frayed collect. Alright? So, dito, alamin natin who actually paid the freight. Sino ang nagbayad ng pamasahe? Alright? So kapag freight, prepaid, parang prepaid load lang to. You need to pay first, no, for the service before you can enjoy the same. Okay? So if freight, prepaid tayo, parang LBC lang. Kapag ni-require ka na ni LBC na bayaran agad yung shipment, right? Situate na yung sender. Excuse me. The sender is the one who actually paid the freight. Pero kapag sinabi natin freight collect, hindi binayaran ni sender yung freight. Sino ang magbabayad? Sisingilin ni LBC yung recipient. That's why pag free collect, always remember, no, na yung recipient, again, the recipient is the one who actually paid the freight. Right? Hindi po si sending. Okay? Sir, bakit kailangan malaman yan? Kailangan malaman yan because magmamatter yan, no, dito sa mga journal entries natin. Again, this will matter, no, dito sa mga journal entries natin. So, transaction number 5, again, pinalitan ko lang, ha, transaction number 5, lagyan ngayon natin ito ng freight. Okay? So, lalagay ko dito, freight. And then the freight is equal to 5,000 pesos. And then sabihin na natin na prepaid muna. Again, freight, prepaid. Okay? So what will happen to our journal entries ngayong nilagyan na, no, ng freight yung transaction? Okay? So here, sa books ni Branch, see to it that another account will immerse, no, and that's the freight in account. So debit freight in equal to 5,000 pesos. Again, debit freight in equal to 5,000 pesos. Okay? Apparently, freight prepaid, meaning the sender is the one who actually paid the freight. Well, in that in this case, it's the home office. That's why credit 5,000 sa libro ni home office. Now, hear me out. Once again, hear me out. See, Branch dapat ang magbayad neto. Because if the problem is silent, always shipping point ang ating kinoconsider. Tama ba? Pag shipping point, right, the one responsible for the freight is actually this recipient. In this case, that's the Branch. Okay? So si Branch dapat ang magbayad ng 5K, pero binayaran yun ni home office. So if binayaran yun ni home office, parang ang isipin mo na lang, binigyan ng pambayad, no, ni home office si Branch. So if the home office gave 5,000 pesos to Branch, right, in order for the Branch to pay the freight, see to it now that there is an asset transfer from the home office to the Branch. That is why here, reciprocal accounts must be increased. So instead of 120,000, IIB must be debited, no, to 125,000. As well as the HOKA must be credited to 125,000 pesos. Right? So these are the journal entries here in transaction number 5. Again, these are the journal entries here in transaction number 5. Okay? Now, transaction number 6 tayo. Here in transaction number 6, right? Lalagay ko pa rin, same. It's just that this time, freight collect naman tayo. Again, freight collect naman tayo. Right? So pag freight collect, the credit to cash, no, is seen on the Branch books. Wala sa home office. So ililibat ko dito, no, yung credit sa cash, which is equal to 5,000 pesos. So pag freight collect, recipient ang nagbayad. Si Branch dapat ang magbayad dito at si Branch talagang nagbayad. So ang ibig sabihin, no need to increase, no, the reciprocal account. So ibig sabihin, as is, at 120,000 yung IIB at yung HOKA. Okay? So that is transaction number 6. Again, that is transaction number 6. Okay? Idiretso na natin sa transaction number 7. Anong meron dito sa transaction number 7 natin? Here, in transaction number 7, magkakaroon ng return, no? Again, there will be return of merchandise. Again, there will be return of merchandise. So kapag nagkaroon ng return of merchandise, see to it na this is from what? This is from Branch going to what? Going to the home office. Again, this is from Branch going to the home office. So if that's the case na nagkaroon, no, ng return of merchandise, all you have to do here, no, is to reverse, again, to reverse the journal entry na ginawa mo doon sa shipment. Ganun lang naman yun. So instead of debiting IIB, will credit IIB. Instead of debiting STB and FOB, will debit those two. Okay? So kailangan mo lang namang i-reverse yung journal entry mo dun sa shipment with regards to what? With regards to the return of merchandise. So that is transaction number 7. Okay? Siyempre, ang daming scenario nilagay ko dito. Alam ka naman, isa-isahin natin pagdating sa return. Reverse na lang. Okay? Let's now move on, no, to transaction number 8. Okay? Sa transaction number 8 is sales to customers, right? Again, transaction number 8 will be the sales to customers, right? So kapag si home office nakapagbenta sa labas, the journal entry is what? The journal entry is to debit what? To debit accounts receivable or cash, depende, no, kung anong na-receive niya. Okay? And then we credit sales. As you can see, walang pakialam ang branch kapag nakapagbenta ang home office. Okay? And then apparently, lagay ko dito home office. Okay? Then transaction number 9, sales to customers pa din. Again, sales to customers pa din. And then apparently dito, lalagay natin branch. Okay? So kapag si branch naman ang nakapagbenta, we debit AR or cash, depending on the scenario, and then we credit sales. So as you can see here, hindi rin gumalaw yung reciprocal accounts. If yung reciprocal accounts hindi naman gumalaw, situate na, no entry ka dapat sa kabila. So here, kapag yung home office nagbenta no, sa labas, we have no entry on the branch books. Kapag si branch nakapagbenta naman no, sa kanyang mga customers, walang pakialam dyan si home office. That's why we have no entry on the home office books. Okay ba tayo dun? Okay? Hopefully okay tayo dun, no? Now, punta tayo sa transaction number 10. Transaction number 10 is the collection. Again, transaction 10, no? Is the collection of accounts receivables. Again, transaction 10 is the collection of accounts receivables. Okay? So here, in the collection of accounts receivable, there are two things, no, that you need to know. Again, dalawang bagay ang gusto ko malaman mo. First, again, first, is who paid the receivable. Ah, ito lang. Alitin ko, ah. First is who collected the receivables. So collected by the receivables. And then, sino ang may-ari ng mga receivables na to? So owned by the receivables. Why? Because whoever is the entity who collected no the accounts receivable, that entity is the one who will debit cash. On the other hand, kung sino may ari ng accounts receivable, that entity is the one who will credit accounts receivables, right? So let's say here, the owner is the home office and it is also collected no by the home office. So if the owner is the home office no and it is also collected by the home office, the journal entry is to debit cash, okay? And then to debit sales discounts kasi possible na may sales discounts din, and then to credit accounts receivable. Hindi naman tinamaan or wala naman sa journal entry yung reciprocal accounts. Therefore, we have no entry no. Again, we have no entry on the branch books. Okay? Ngayon, punta tayo sa transaction number 11. Again, here, in transaction number 11, medyo papalitan ko lang to ng konti. Okay? Here in transaction number 11, alright, instead na it is collected by the home office, this time, let's say it is collected by the branch. Okay? So if si branch ang nakakolekta, sabi ko nga, yung debit to cash, dapat nandito sa branch. So debit cash, sa libro ni branch. But since ang may-ari no is si home office, situate na si home office ang magde-debit ng sales discount at magki-credit ng accounts receivable. Okay? So ngayon ganito. Since si home office ang may-ari ng accounts receivable, the one that is parabang the one that is that has the right no to collect the same is the home office. Si home office dapat no ang naka-receive ng cash. Kay home office dapat yung cash na yan. It's just that it is collected no by the branch. So ang isipin mo ngayon, parang nakolekta ni parang ang nakakolekta talaga niyan is si home office. It's just that the home office no sent the collection to the branch. Ulitin ko. Ang isipin mo, dumaan mo na yan kay home office. Si home office talagang nakakolekta and then yung cash na nakolekta niya, binigay niya kay branch. That's why may debit to cash sa branch. So if that's the case, there will be what? There will be an asset transfer no from the home office to the branch. Therefore, the reciprocal accounts must be increased. So to increase the IIB account, we need to debit it. So debit IIB account. Then para ma-increase yung HOCA, kailangan natin yung i-credit. That's why we'll credit home office current account here. So that's transaction number 11. Okay? So now, punta tayo sa transaction number 12. Again, let's now move on no, sa transaction number 12. Transaction number 12, collected by the branch, owned by the branch. Okay? So, buruin ko lang to. So, if it is collected no, by the branch, the debit to cash is seen in the branch books. Okay? Since ang may-ari is si branch din, the debit to sales discount, and then to the credit to accounts receivable, makikita mo rin yun kay branch books. Since hindi naman, no, para bang gumalaw yung reciprocal account or yung HOKA account sa libro ni branch, hindi rin dapat nagagalaw yung IIB account. So we have no entry on home office books. Okay? Ngayon, punta tayo sa transaction number 13. Again, let's now move on here in transaction number 13. Okay? So here, in transaction number 13, let's say what? Let's say this time, it is collected by the home office. So if it is collected by the home office, see to it na yung debit to cash, dapat na kay home office yun. Ang may-ari si branch, tama ba? So yung debit to sales discount at credit to AR, na kay branch pa din yun. Okay? So here, ang isipin mo na lang, si branch ang may karapatan dyan. Si branch dapat ang may cash. Pero si home office yung kumolekta. Right? So sir, possible pala yun? Yes, possible yun. Let's say banko. Porket ba yung account mo? Nasa Maynila? Sa Maynila ka lang pwedeng mag-withdraw? Di naman, tama ba? Pwede kang mag-withdraw. Saan? Pwede kang mag-withdraw sa Tarlac branch. Parang ganun lang yun. Okay? So see to it here na ang isipin mo na lang, si branch talaga yung nakakolekta ng cash. It's just that that cash is remitted, no, by the branch to the home office. Therefore, there will be an asset transfer from the branch going to the home office. And if that's the case, reciprocal accounts will be decreased. Okay? So, paano bawasan yung IIB? Kailangan natin yung i-credit. And how to decrease HOKA? Kailangan mo yung i-debit. So, these are the journal entries here in transaction number 13. Okay? So, dito inahati natin yung normal na journal entry, no? So, burahin ko lang para may susulatan tayo.